This is the true story of one man's journey with one camera on one continent, riding a motorcycle through a world of chaos.
So this isn't the presidential tour with Forest Sawyer, but this is the village tour with Mike.
In Africa, there are many things that can kill you. But in Rwanda, it's not the roads, hunger, or disease. It's the people. These are children behind me. Children. The 1994 genocide, 800,000 Rwandans dead in 100 days. These children were killed with a cheap, made-in-China machete. First, they'd slice their ankles or break their leg so they couldn't run away. And if they didn't cut their stomachs open, they'd crack their skulls. Rwandans were doing this to Rwandans. Hutus were killing Hutus. Pregnant women with babies on their back were killing other pregnant women with babies on their back. Why? Maybe they acted out of fear. Genocide hasn't ended. It's moved. The U.S. Department of State continues to warn U.S. citizens against travel to the Democratic Republic of Congo, as there are many dangerous conditions for both residents and visitors.
So welcome to the Congo. We're here.
17,500 U.N. peacekeeping forces remain in the DR Congo due to continued attacks by uncontrolled militia. Armed militia groups and some active duty troops are known to pillage, carjack and steal vehicles, kill expeditiously, rape, kidnap, and carry out military, paramilitary operations.
This is the national road. This is the international passageway for Congo. Have you ever seen one like it? Okay, so you say hello to the camera. Say hello. Both these guys are Hutu rebels. They came from Rwanda.
And as the UN helicopters fly overhead, the rebels terrorize the local population. 5 million dead since 1996.
The government of Kinshasa doesn't pay its police force or its military over here in eastern Congo.
So they're one of the main reasons for terrorizing the public. And so it's very likely I'll be asked for many bribes along the journey. So what I brought was soap. If you're gonna bribe, make it a clean one.
Okay, so these are the guys. These are the ones who are protecting this national park against the Burundian rebels and the Rwandan rebels, Interahamwe. And as you can see, they got these weapons everywhere. RPG-7. That does some damage. So I brought them as gifts.
Yes.
This is the soap. This is the magic bribe. This is what I've been talking
about. Yes.
So everyone gets soap.
Yes.
Sebon. So I knew this stuff would work. Soap. It's the cleanest bribe in the whole world.
So there's nothing like a good old-fashioned police chase to get the heart pumping. Today I decided I had enough about the police checkpoints, and I started to run them. Just drive right through them. Wave to the people, tell them see you next time, a la prochaine. And I got about 20 kilometers out of town and two guys on a motorcycle show up right next to me and tell me to slow down. So I slow down but leave the engine running. And a guy gets comes towards me quite aggressively, both in civilian uniforms, don't identify themselves or anything. And he tells me that I have to go back because the police officer is looking for a white person. And then he grabbed the keys out of the ignition, thinking he was going to shut the ignition off, but he didn't shut it off. The engine was still running. And so I just knew right then and there, it's time to go. And I floored it. And I've been racing for the last 70 or 80 kilometers. And I'm free now. Because they can't communicate with Kisangani. Because they don't have radio. They don't have energy. They don't have cell phones here.
I'm in North Kivu now. Second largest territory of Hutu rebels in the entire world.
Okay, so they just fed me, so now I gotta give something back.
Sometimes I feel like I could do anything, and sometimes I'm so alive, so alive. Sometimes I feel like I could swim across the sky, yeah. Sometimes I wanna cry. People try to aim to please, but a lot of them are kinda weak in the knees. Learning late about the birds and the bees. Falling in love, want to be set free. Playing ball at the age of 13. Everybody's going up with a dream. I never noticed what could happen to me. Time flies when you walk in the streets. One minute got you holding the name.